Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Today we have a topic with us as capitalization rate or cap rate, one of the very important percentage or a capitalization ratio or a rate basically. It's a percentage which is used for discounting your cash flows. So let's read a couple of things here. Capitalization rate usually is called as the cap rate, which is used in the real estate industry. And it is the rate is the ratio of the net operating income and the market value of the asset. Okay, this was a little bit of technical. We'll try and work on this in a very simplistic manner. Now, first and the foremost thing, what is the cap rate? We'll try and understand this at the very initial stage. See, the capitalization rate is the ratio of the net operating income and the market value of the asset. So it is usually called as the cap rate and is commonly used in the real estate industry. Now, capitalization rate is often used in the commercial real estate industry. It can be used to compare the returns. It can be used to compare the returns of the commercial real estate industry, and it can be used for the potential properties up for the acquisition. Now, one property earning a higher capitalization rate would be considered a better investment than the other property, given other conditions are similar to that location of the building and so on and so forth. So thus it allows the quick comparison of the earning potential. What earning potential of the, you can say, that investment properties, and you know, it can be held, it can help you to choose the best investment opportunity. Now, capitalization rate can give a sort of an indication of a trend that can follow, a trend of the real estate prices. So if the cap rates are shrinking, it may mean that the value of the properties are increasing, and thus the real estate market as a whole is heating up. Okay, this was about the what part. How about we learn about the formula now? See, the capitalization rate formula, the cap rate formula, is equal to your net operating income divided by the market value of the asset. This is going to be your formula. Cap rate is net operating income divided by the market value of the asset. So over here, the net operating income of a rental property, it is basically what we call as the rent minus the expenses that is paid for maintenance. Now, cap rate formula can also be thought as of, like, you know, a return base, return on investment, and an investor will receive annually on the purchase of the real estate property. So that can be a thing. Third, what we are going to take is over here the example part. We'll take the first example, example number one. Let's say, suppose there is an office building which gives us the net operating income as, let's say, $10 million, and it is valued at, let's say, $7.5 million. Let's say it is valued at $7.5 million. Now, using the above cap formula, we can calculate the capitalization rate. It is as simple as that. 10 and 7.5, just divide both of this above. You have 1.33. So if we calculate in terms of percentages, okay, so 10 divided by 7.5 into 100. So that's closely around 13.33%, right? And thus, if the building is sold for 70, let's say instead of 7.5, let's say 75, and over here 100, then the amount will change. So 10 divided by 75, let's say 10 million and valued at 75, then 13% is the value. So if the building is sold for $75 million, it can also be said that the building was sold at 13% cap. Okay, I'll take another example, example number two. Well, let us have a look at the another cap rate example. Let's say the rental property gets $1,000 gross income every month. So the owner is liable to annually pay how much? $700 for the property management. Let's say $700 for property management. Let's say $500 for property taxes and $250 for insurance. Okay, so he bought of the property, let's say he bought the property for, let's say, $80,000. So in this case, we have a gross income and the expenses incurred by the owner. Thus, we'll try and calculate the net operating income on the property. So over here, the NOI is equal to your gross income less your property management less your taxes insurance part. Okay, So NOI will be is equal to 1000 into 12 minus, once you do that, you'll need to deduct 700 from that, 500 and less 250. Deduct all these expenses. That's 10,550. So now the cap rate calculation, that is NOI divided by the property price, is gonna be 10,550 divided by, he bought it for how much? 80,000, right? So I'll just simply write 80,000. So that's 13.18%. Right. Now let's try and discuss, is high cap rate always better? Is it better? See, cap rates can be good estimate to compare different investment property, but higher cap rate does not usually mean that better investment opportunity. Cap rates are important, but investor needs to look into the parameters as well. Capitalization rate can be considered as a measure for the capitalization rate can be considered as a measure of the riskiness of the investment, right? So usually a lower cap rate implies low risk. A lower cap rate implies low risk, and a higher cap rate implies higher risk. A comparison. Okay, this was on this part. Let's consider the disadvantages of the capitalization rate. Now, can be used only when the net operating income is constant or does not fluctuate much. So by using this cap rate, is the valuation would be somewhat similar to that from the DCF technique, that is discounted cash flow technique. However, the cash flow is complex and irregular with a lot of variation. So a full discounted cash flow method should be used to get the credible and reliable valuations. Capitalization rate may take into account various factors, but it does not reflect the future risk. It does not reflect the future risk. So capitalization rate assumes that, you know, a sustainable income from the real estate property, but no guarantee could be made of such an assumption. So the rent may appreciate or depreciate. So the property value may change due to external circumstances on which the investor does not have any control. So the expenses such as maintenance expense may rise, and thus the cap rate does not offer any guidance on the prediction about the future risk. So let me make my final conclusion this particular topic after discussing so many other topics in the same subtopics. See, capitalization rate is a comparative metric. It is a comparative metric, and which is most useful to compare similar properties, that is properties in a similar location, so similar asset class with similar age. So the metric is still widely used for commercial and multi-asset real estate valuation, but real estate investor use it to as a tool to value their investment and make an informal decisions. Okay, they make an informal decision. However, you know, the investor should not consider cap rate as go-to metric, but also consider various other factors which may impact the asset value. So it is important metric, but not an exhaustive measure.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.